Hallelujah, hallelujah. The Lord our God is mighty. The Lord our God is powerful. The Lord our God is awesome. He is our strength. He is our redeemer, and we give him all praise. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Welcome, and we thank you for tuning in to Midday Glory. I'm Reverend Gwendolyn Dixon, and I will be your host for the next 20 minutes. Still on the subject, what does God expect of us? We've discussed thus far that God expects from us that we would know his word and that we'll be a doer of his word. So the first thing that we discussed was the word teaches us to love one another. So John 13, verses 34 and 35 says, a new commandment I give unto you, that ye love one another as I have loved you, that ye also love one another. By this shall all men know that ye are my disciples, if you have loved one another. And then the second thing that the word teaches us is to love our enemies. Glory to God. Matthew 5:44, but I say unto you, love your enemies, bless them that curse you, do good to them that hate you, and pray for them which despitefully use you and persecute you. Glory to God. That's a powerful scripture. So today we're going to discuss the word God teaches us to pray for one another. James 5:16 says, confess your faults one to another, and pray for one another that ye may be healed. The effectual, fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. In the Word of God, he commands believers to pray for one another, as well as he commands us to love, as well as he commands us to love our enemies. Praying for one another, even our enemies, as part of the Christian life. There are seven tragical, astonished things God does when we pray for one another. Number one, when we pray for one another, God answers. Number two, when we pray for one another, God heals us. Number three, when we pray for one another, God opens doors for the gospel. Number four, when we pray for one another, God grows us. We grow spiritually, glory to God. We mature spiritually. Number five, when we pray for one another, God lifts our burdens. Number six, when we pray for one another, God humbles us. And then number seven, when we pray for one another, God helps us overcome sin. Glory to God. We're going to discuss all of these seven tragical things and astonishing things that God does for us when we pray for one another. May I get to all seven today, glory to God. So we must pray. We must pray and be prayed for, glory to God. Now, the Apostle Paul told the Ephesians to pray for one another, and then he asked them to pray for him as well. In Ephesians 6, verses 18 and 19, says, praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, and watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all saints, and for me, that utterance may be given unto me, that I may open my mouth boldly to make known the mystery of the gospel. Now let's think about this scripture for a minute. Paul, who is the great apostle, who led thousands to the Lord, who had been caught up into the third heaven, appeared to his fellow believers to pray for him. Paul didn't think that he was so highly of himself. He didn't think so highly of himself or think that he was too strong in the Lord, that he didn't need others to pray for him. He asked them to strive in prayer to God for him. He asked them to pray for his faith. He asked them to pray for his service, that it would be acceptable to the saints in Jerusalem. My God. This demonstrated the humility that Paul had for the Lord. This speaks volumes of a man who has such a high office in the ministry. He didn't exhort himself so high that he didn't think that others should not pray for him, glory to God. You see, Apostle Paul knew he needed the prayers of the believers. He literally asked them to pray for him. God's word will humble us just like Apostle Paul, and we will seek the prayers of others, glory to God. Apostle Paul also prayed constantly for others. He was a strong, powerful prayer warrior. Glory be to God. He told the Galatians in chapter 1, verse 9, that he prayed for them. He says, for this cause also, since the day we heard it, do not cease to pray for you, and to desire that ye might be filled with the knowledge of his will and all wisdom and spiritual understanding. Paul didn't assume that the Galatians believers would automatically keep growing in their spiritual wisdom and knowledge. He prayed constantly for them. Glory to God. In this world that we are living in today, there is a desperate need for one another like never before. Paul's example demonstrates how incredibly important it is for us to pray for one another. We desperately need one another, glory to God. If we focus on the Word of God, and if we pray for ourselves and others, it keeps us abiding in His Word. It keeps our focus on the Lord. Hallelujah. It was never intended for us as Christians to live alone, to be by ourselves. We can't do it by ourselves. That's why God says in His Word in Hebrews 10:25, don't forsake the assembling of ourselves together as a manner of some is, but exhorting one another. And so much the more as you see the day approaching. In other words, don't forsake the meeting together with other believers for worship service, for instruction of the Word of God. It gives each and every one of us strength. It encourages one another. It's important for believers that we must be faithful, glory to God, as we see that the day of Christ is coming soon. His coming, His approaching, His return is coming soon. So often we forget just how much that we need each other. God tells us to lift one another up. In 1 Thessalonians 5:11, He says, wherefore, comfort yourselves together, edify one another, even also as also ye do. And then we need one another to get through this life, just this general life, through affliction that we go through a temptation, through hurt and through pain, glory to God. God tells us that we must pray for one another. God never tells us to do anything that He doesn't intend to respond to, glory to God. Let's take a look at the staggering things God does when we pray for one another. Number one, when we pray for one another, believers, God answers, glory to God. In Matthew 18:19, it says, again, I say unto you, that if two of you agree on earth as touching anything that they shall ask, it shall be done for them of my Father which is in heaven. God tells us here that He will answer the prayers of just two believers who pray for anything in agreement together, glory to God. We pray in accordance to the Word of God, hallelujah. That is just so amazing and so absolutely awesome and breathtaking when we pray the Word of God, glory to God. When we walk in obedience, it is such a blessing. When two believers pray, God will do anything that we ask, glory to God. There is absolutely nothing impossible with God, and He responds in such a unique, powerful way, Father God, that we just bless His name, glory to God. When believers come together, when we join together on one accord, glory to God, loving one another, loving our enemies, praying for one another, God will answer our prayers, glory to God. And then number two, when believers pray for one another, God also heals. In James 5:13-15, it says, is any man among you afflicted? Let him pray. Is any merry? Let him sing songs. Is any sick among you? Let him call for the elders of the church and let them pray over him, anointing him with oil in the name of the Lord. And the prayer of faith shall save the one sick, and the Lord shall raise him up, glory to God. And if he has committed sins, they shall be forgiven him. James tells us that if we are sick, that we should ask the elders of the church to pray for us and anoint us with oil. The result is that God will use those prayers to heal us, glory to God. James then tells the whole church to pray for one another. James assures us that our prayers for one another are powerful, glory to God, though they may not even feel powerful. He says the effectual, the earnest, fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. It has great power and produces wonderful results, glory to God. He backs this up by reminding us that Elijah's prayer was so powerful to God that it stopped the rain for 3 years, then it started again. So we may say, but that was Elijah the prophet. But James assures us that Elijah was a man with a nature just like ours. In other words, he was just like us. He was a normal human being, glory to God. And his prayers had great power. So James tells us who are believers that our prayers have great power, glory to God, and that we don't feel it, and even if we don't feel the power, glory to God, hallelujah. Pray for one another earnestly because there is great power in those prayers. We pray and we wait patiently. We believe our prayers will be answered, glory to God. Just have faith and trust the Lord. And then number three, God opened doors when we pray for one another. Apostle Paul knew that there was a direct connection between people praying for him and the effectiveness of his ministry. So he regularly asked people to pray that God would open doors for the gospel. And Galatians 4:3 says, with the praying also for us, that God would open unto us a door of utterance to speak the mystery of Christ, for which I also am in bond. And then in 2 Thessalonians 3:1, he says, finally, brethren, pray for us, that the word of the Lord may have free course and be glorified even as it is with you. When we pray for one another, God uses those prayers to soften hearts. He uses those prayers to open doors. He uses those prayers to draw us even closer to himself. Glory to God. Hallelujah. When we pray using the name of Jesus, glory to God, God uses our prayers for one another to bring about his kingdom here on this earth. And then the fourth staggering thing is when we pray for one another, God grows us. We mature spiritually in him. Philippians 1 verses 9 through 11, it says, and this I pray, that your love may abound yet more and more in knowledge and in all judgment, that ye may approve things that are excellent, that you may be sincere and without offense at the day of Christ, being filled with the truth, with the fruit of righteousness, glory to God, whereof by Jesus Christ unto the glory and praise of God. Glory to God. Paul understood that prayer was the instrumental in helping people become more like Christ. Hallelujah. In other words, Paul didn't just simply assume that the Philippians would automatically become more like Jesus. He knew that in some ways their spiritual growth was directly connected to his prayers. So if we want to be more like Christ, we must pray for ourselves as well as pray for others. Pray that God would increase our love for him. If we truly love the Lord, hallelujah, and if we truly abide in his word, we will truly love and pray for others for spiritual knowledge and discernment. Glory to God. Pray that we will be filled with the fruit of righteousness. When we pray for one another, God shapes and he molds us more into the image of him. Hallelujah. Because of the so I'm going to have to stop right here because of the time. I'm looking at the time, so we must go into prayer. So next week, we will continue on with the next three strategizing things, the astonishing things that God will do when we pray for one another, when we are doers of his word. Glory to God. Let us pray. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. Oh, God, thank you, Lord God, for just reminding us of the simple things, oh, God, that we must do, Lord God. It's not a hard task that we truly love you, Lord God. It's not a hard task to pray for one another. It's not a hard task to love one another. It's not a hard task to love our enemies. Even, Father God, we could not see ourselves loving our enemies, Lord God. But when we love you, Lord God, and we want to abide in your word, and when we want to do your word, Lord God, it will be easy, oh Lord God, hallelujah, to cast all of our burdens over to you, to cast all of those, oh God, that persecute us, those that do evil against us, Lord God, hallelujah. We glorify your name today, God. You are our heavenly Father, Lord God. You are God, and beside you there is no one else, Lord God. You are such an awesome God. You reign, almighty God, forevermore. You are almighty God, hallelujah. You are the all-powerful, all-sufficient God. You are the one, almighty God, hallelujah. We exhort, Lord God. We extol you, Lord God. We magnify and we glorify your name, God. You are Jesus the Christ. You are Lord over everything, hallelujah. All power is in your hands, hallelujah. We thank you so much, Father God, for this subject. What does God expect of us, glory to God? You expect nothing that is not impossible, Lord God, hallelujah. You expect us to be doers of your word, glory be to God. We desire, almighty God, to walk in the spirit of obedience, Lord God, to do your will for ourselves as well as others, Lord God. We know that prayer is powerful and prayer changes things, hallelujah. Your word says that we should pray without ceasing, Lord God. Pray for one another, Lord God, that God, you would deliver us from all temptation of sin, Lord God. Oh, we know so much, Father God, hallelujah. We know, Father God, you have done so much for us, Lord God. When we pray for one another, Lord God, you give us boldness, Lord God. You increase our love for one another, Lord God. You rescue us, Father God, from the horrible pit. You heal all manner of sickness and diseases, Lord God, and you deliver us out of bondage, hallelujah. Lord God, when we pray for one another, it humbles us, hallelujah. You give us the strength that we need.
need, Almighty God, to go forth and to do your will, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, for lifting our burdens, hallelujah. And we thank you for lifting the burdens of others, hallelujah. We pray, Almighty God, for those that are so less fortunate than we are, Lord God. We pray for those who are sick, Lord God. We pray for those, oh God, who are afflicted with disease in the name of Jesus, Lord God. We pray, Almighty God, for those who are in the hospital right now, Lord God. Father God, the doctors have been by their bedside, Lord God, and the news have been not so good, Lord God, hallelujah. They wanted positive news, but what the doctor said, God, is not, Father God, what they want to hear, Lord God. There's somebody, Father God, that's in the hospital, that's in surgery right now as we pray, God. There's somebody, Lord God, that's waiting to go into surgery, Lord God. There's someone, Almighty God, that is waiting on a transplant right now, God, in the name of Jesus, God. We cover them in prayer, God. We cover them, Almighty God, in the blood of Jesus, Father God, right now on this hour. We pray, Almighty God, for those that are in hospice care, Lord God. Those, oh Lord God, that have, the doctor said there's nothing else that they can do, God. We pray for those caregivers, oh God, who have to watch their loved ones, Father God, suffer, Lord God. We pray, Almighty God, on this day, Father God, for the homeless, Lord God. Those, oh God, do not have a warm place to go. God, we pray and we thank you, God, for churches and different places that open doors, oh God, that the homeless can go in, Father God, from this frigid cold, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, God. Father God, we pray today, God, for financial breakthroughs, God. We pray today, Lord God, for the government, Lord God. We pray, Lord God, hallelujah, and we thank you, Lord God, for the furlough, Father God, being lifted, Lord God, that those federal employees, oh God, may be paid, Lord God. We don't know what's going to happen on February the 15th, but God, we know that you do, Lord God. We know that you know everything, Lord God, hallelujah. So, Father God, we rest in you, Lord God. We put everything in you because you are in control, God. You are in charge of everything, hallelujah. You supply all of our needs according to your riches and glory. No man, hallelujah, is in charge of anything, God. Everything belongs to you, glory to God. So we thank you, Father God, hallelujah, for every church, God. We thank you for every organization, every helper, Lord God, who came together, Lord God, to help those affected by the furlough, God. We know it was a hardship, but there is absolutely nothing too hard for you, Lord God. We know you are the God who answers prayer, Lord God. We pray, Almighty God, that during the furlough, Lord God, that we, Father God, took the time, God, to really sup with you, Lord God, to really, Lord God, Father God, be in praise and worship with you, Lord God, to be in your very presence, oh Lord God, so that our faith could increase, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, that we use our time wiser, God. We pray, Almighty God, that believers took the time to really get in your word, Lord God, trusting and believing, Almighty God, that you will see them through in the name of Jesus, God. We walk by faith and not by sight. We must not allow man to control our faith, hallelujah. We must remain focused on you at all times, God, all through the good times as well as the bad times. We desire to live according to your word, God. Bless and cleanse us, Almighty God, hallelujah. Deliver us from all evil, Lord God. Wash us and we will be whiter than snow, Lord God. We confess our sin, Lord God. We know that we are only sinners, saved by your grace, Lord God. Cleanse our ears, Almighty God, that we may hear your word, Lord God, that we may hear your voice, oh God. Clean our ears, our eyes, oh my God, that when we look at others, God, we will see them as you see them, Lord God. Hallelujah, Lord God. And if we see someone that is in a fault, God, let us pray, hallelujah. Let our hearts, Father God, have that love, that unconditional love, God, that you have for us, God. Let us love others, God, as your word says, Father God, so that we can be blessed and they can be blessed. Hallelujah, glory to God. Thank you, Father God, for giving us life and giving it to us, oh God, more abundantly. We pray for our enemies on this day. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You are our strength and you are our redeemer. We pray for churches and pastors worldwide, Lord God. Lord God, open the doors for the gospel, Lord God. Let there be a revival that will begin in us, Lord God. We need, Father God, to be resurrected from the things that we are surrounded by, Lord God. Help us, oh Lord God, to worship you like never before, God. Let us not be tossed to and fro by every wind, Lord God, but let us be steadfast, unmovable, always abiding in you. Lord God, don't let us just preach your word and teach your word, but let us be doers of your word in the mighty name of Jesus, God. We know that we are living in the last and evil days, Lord God. Signs are all around us, oh God. We must pray for one another like never before, Lord God. We know, Almighty God, that prayer of a righteous availeth much. Prayer has great power, hallelujah. We continue to pray, Almighty God. You said a man ought to always pray, hallelujah, and never faint, Lord God. We love you, Lord God. We bless you, and we bless your holy name, Lord God. And this is your servant's prayer, God, in the mighty name of Jesus, God, in the matchless name of Jesus, oh God. We pray this prayer, and we say amen, amen, and amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. We don't want you to stop. We want you to stay tuned in. Glory to God for I don't know how long the Lord is going to have us on this subject, but it is a blessing to me. I love it when God reminds us of what we need to be doing as Christians. Sometimes we fall by the wayside, but he loves us so much. His word constantly reminds us. Stay blessed, and we pray that we will hear you on the line next week. God bless you richly in Jesus' name. Bye-bye.